Haven't you been getting tired of all these Minecraft items? You're using them so much, and let's be honest now, it's getting kind of boring. You see this golden sword? Well, let me tell you, I've been there and done that. You see this gray die? Pshaw! It's old, man. Old. Well, you see every single one of these pillars? Every single one of these pillars is actually an item if you look closer. And you can get all of these awesome items with special abilities and all sorts of cool stuff with no mods at all. It's amazing. Amazing. Like, look at the stuff I'm wearing right now. I'm wearing a cape. I have a diamond battle axe, a blue jay bow. Woo! In your face, literally, bros. Look at that. Look at that. And then I got a handgun, too. It's shooting. And look at that. There's an animation on the side of the gun. It's so crazy. Look at all these stuff I'm wearing. It's crazy. Now, you might be thinking, how do you get all these stuff without any mods? I mean, it's amazing, like I said. Well, this is actually a resource pack, and this was actually created for you guys because some of you guys, it's very hard for you guys to run mods, and lots of us want mods. And resource packs are so easy to install, and almost anybody can install them. So this was created, and it's so awesome, so awesome. This resource pack is called Item Bound. I said item bound, right? It's called item bound. I can speak today. And yeah, so if you, I'm just gonna give you guys a glimpse of all these awesome items. It's so cool. If you like these items and you wanna know how to craft them, how to get the resource pack, I'm gonna be showing you guys how to do that today in the video. So stick around to find out how to get all these awesome items. Alright, so first, I want to show you guys how you can actually kind of the basics on how to make all of these awesome items. Basically, if you may have noticed, we have a lot of anvils here. I wonder how much iron that is. I will never be able to get that much iron in my survival world. But all you need is one anvil, of course. I just put lots of anvils to make it very fancy. So basically, yeah. How you craft all of these items is actually you'd take a vanilla item and then you'd rename it in an anvil. So, for example, let's take this wooden spear right here. Now, if we wanted this wooden spear, then we would put a wooden sword inside an anvil and we rename it into a wooden spear. Now, in 3, 2, 1. Look at that, the texture changes into a wooden spear. It's named a wooden spear. Now, if you notice something, I have another wooden sword right here. If you look at these two wooden spears, this wooden sword has the same attack speed and attack damage as this wooden spear. They have the exact same stats because this is actually originally a wooden sword. But that's not how all the items work. Some items have special abilities. For example, we have a flame bow, right? I mean, a blaze bow. A blaze bow. Flame bow is vanilla. We're not in vanilla anymore. This is a modded. This doesn't have mods. It's a resource pack that acts like a mod. It's crazy. So, we're gonna try to make a blaze bow. Now, how you do that is you take a bow and you put it in an anvil. Now, you see, this is called a blaze bow. So, if we were to rename this into a blaze bow, it doesn't turn into this, and it doesn't have flame on it. So, actually, for some of the items, you need to add an enchanted book to it. You'll see, when I put this enchanted book on it, it's actually gonna change into the blaze bow. Boom! Whoo! It's the blaze bow! What do you know? That's pretty cool, am I right? That is pretty cool. And it shoots flame. Who would have guessed? I wouldn't have guessed that. Now, some items do have the enchantment that you give them, but some items, like these mob drops here, you actually, and these fish and stuff, which is crazy. Let's look at this one. If you get an enderfish, which you can fish with a fishing rod, it randomly teleports the player within a limited radius. And this blood lamprey gives the player an HP boost when held in the offhand slot, which is sick. So you can have special abilities, and this isn't even a mod. It's so crazy. So now that you know how to craft the basics, you can craft basics now, right? Right? Now that you know how to craft all these basics, I'm going to show you specifically how to craft more items. So let's go and place back this wooden spear. I want to show you guys the wooden dagger. Now, the wooden dagger, it goes right there. I don't know why I was here. But maybe you can't see it. But if I go into third-person mode, look, you can see the wooden dagger right there. Isn't that so cool? And again, it has the same stuff as a wooden sword. So 1.6 attack damage, 4 attack damage, 1.6 attack damage, 4 attack damage. It's sick. And then you can attack with it. So, boom. 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 You don't really see it, but boom. Boom. So we have a scythe. We have a battle axe, a rapier, a trident, a longsword, a katana, a dagger, a nunchuck, and a spear. Now, even though these are all like wooden swords right here, it would be kind of cool if you wanted to like dress up with the other like added armor and masks and stuff. You could dress up and like be a ninja with your awesome nunchuck. Hoo-ya! See, because I'm a ninja. Get it? Get it? Get it? Hoo-ya! Hoo-ya! Oh, MLG, oh my god, look at those skills. Ooh, 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 oh, you never saw anything like that, did you? You didn't, yeah. Alright, so, basically, we have all these weapons that I just showed you. We have them in the stone line. So, these stone stuff are the exact same things, but they're like a stone sword. So, 1.6 attack damage, 5 attack damage. Then we have the same things with a gold sword. We have the same thing with iron sword. And again, you just put this in an anvil, an iron sword, and you just rename it to whatever you want with these things. And we have it for a diamond sword. Then we have the cool stuff. We have special custom swords. What is this called? Swords Plus. That's right, Swords Plus. So we have a sandstone sword, a bedrock sword, an emerald sword, a glass sword, a nether sword, obsidian sword, a rainbow sword, and a red sandstone sword. So, you might be wondering, oh my god, this is so cool, how do I craft all these items? Basically, they're the same thing. You either craft them with a wooden sword, a stone sword, a gold sword, an iron sword, or a diamond sword, and they do that much damage. So, let's look. We have a sandstone sword, which is 1.6 attack damage and 5 attack damage. So, this is crafted with a stone sword. Bedrock sword. You need unbreaking to make it. So basically you take a diamond sword, you rename it into a bedrock sword, and then any unbreaking level is fine. So it doesn't really matter if I wanted to make the bedrock sword and I have all these different unbreaking enchantments, right? I can spell unbreaking. We have unbreaking 3, unbreaking 2, unbreaking 1. So let's say I took unbreaking 1 and unbreaking 2, and then I took myself a diamond sword. Right? And then we'll go over here in the anvil. We'll rename it into a bedrock sword. There we go. But again, it's not going to change the texture until I put unbreaking. Boom! It's a bedrock sword with unbreaking. Again, it works with any unbreaking. So if I put unbreaking 2, boom! Again, it changes into a bedrock sword. It just matters what unbreaking you want. Unbreaking 1, unbreaking 2, or unbreaking 3. Now, let's just pick up that diamond sword. Alright, so now that we have the bedrock sword, the emerald sword. The emerald sword, you need looting, any type of looting again, and a diamond sword. I won't be showing you guys, because you guys can probably figure it out by now. A glass sword. A glass sword is used, I believe you need a wooden sword. I think. Let's test it out. Okay, so we do. Wooden sword. One here. Is it gonna? No. I think it's a gold sword. Gold. Da-da, da-da. And then we do glass. I'm just showing you guys how to craft these things. It's not a gold sword? Huh. Is it? What? Oh, you need smite. My bad. I'm stupid. Yeah. So you take a wooden sword. You guys are probably looking at me like, oh my god, Gabe, you're stupid. So again, any smite, you put glass. It's a golden sword. Glass sword. We did it! Yay! I'm supposed to be reviewing this and I don't know it. That's kind of sad, isn't it? Okay, continuing. We have the nether sword, which is an iron sword. I know it. And you put fire aspect on it. Then we have an obsidian sword, which is a diamond sword, and you put knockback on it. We have a rainbow sword, which is a diamond sword, and you rename it rainbow. And then we have a red sandstone sword, which is a stone sword, and you rename it the red sandstone sword. Yay! Okay. Now we have these. What are these? What are those? These are novelty weapons. So we have a yellow paintbrush, a red paintbrush, a blue paintbrush, a violet paintbrush, a green paintbrush, a microphone, a knife, an iron bat, a wooden bat, that's a wooden bat, a twig, a buster sword, and a brick. All of these are weapons. Basically, none of these have special enchantments on them except for the buster sword, which you rename buster sword. You take an iron sword and you put knockback and you rename it buster sword. But again, I'm not going to tell you guys how to craft everything here. I'm going to leave a link in the description, actually, on how to craft every single item here just for you guys. You're welcome. Lol. Okay. Oops. sorry, knife. See, if you have, like, friends and stuff, which you probably have friends, I hope you have friends, then you can just, like, come up to them and be like, hooyah, you just got slain by a knife. Roasted. Alright, then we got these pin wheels. We got blue, red, yellow, pink, and green. Then we got a wooden racket, an iron racket, a blue bus stop sign, and a work sign. Which is pretty sick. So you can actually come up to your friends with a work sign. And here, let's get a spawn. What do we hate here, okay? Let's spawn an Enderman. Why not an Enderman, right? Okay, so we're gonna spawn an Enderman, and let's see how fast we can kill him with this. You had to teleport? Okay, maybe that wasn't the best choice. Let's take a skeleton. We hate these creepy guys. Slash time set day, are you happy now? I guess, mobs are... There are no mobs in this world. Okay, then. Well, again, so if you wanted to just kill somebody, it would do 6 attack damage. So this is basically like an iron sword, and you could be like, haha, I just killed you with a work sign. You loser. You can make your friends look like losers with this mod. How cool is that? Why do I keep on saying mod? It's not a mod. It's a resource pack, okay? It's a resource pack. Now, we have all these signs, and then we have quills. White quill, gold quill, brown quill, black quill. Then we start getting fancy. Yellow pencil, red pencil, green pencil. Even fancier, we got a black pen, a blue pen, a red pen, a violet pen. Then we get super fancy. Like, super fancy. Like, rich people can only afford these stuff. Okay? You have to spend diamonds making a black fountain pen, a diamond fountain pen, which kind of makes sense, a pearl fountain pen, and a red fountain pen. Those all require diamond swords, and they're very expensive, but they do a ton of damage. They are probably worth it. Like, look at this thing. Look how fast I'm swinging, and it's like a diamond sword. It's sick. All right? Okay. Now, let's just place all these stuff in this inventory. Let's just trash it. Let's trash it. Nobody cares about you. We don't care about you. Nobody will ever care about you. We hate you. Get out of here. Alright. That was weapons. I'll give somebody $100 if they can guess how many weapons that was. No, I won't. I'm just kidding. Please don't. Please don't count how many weapons that was. That was 97 weapons. How did you know? Oh my god. That was 97 weapons. So 97 weapons are added into this mod, which are pretty cool. Then we have tools, I believe. Yeah, armor, masks, heads, and capes, and not tools. I'm smart. Yeah, so let's start from the back. Let's be savages. So this is where stuff get cool. We have plastic sunglasses, shutter shades, and a bikini. Now, these things look really, really ugly. They're leather. But if we take a crafting table and we take dye, let's just grab I love myself some magenta, some cyan, some lime, some orange. Let's just place this crafting table down. Let's take ourselves a bikini, right? If we put this bikini in the crafting table, and then we recolor it, boom! It's blue now. So basically, this is just like leather armor. You actually craft it by placing leather armor. Who knew? And look at that. Look at that. I can make it whatever color I want in the whole entire universe. Universe. I can speak today. No, I can't. So you can do that with sunglasses too, and shutter shades and everything. You can do that with a fedora, and you can do that with a cat post-it, a gasp post-it, a mad post-it, a sad post-it, a smile post-it, and a wink post-it. You see? And you can, like, come up to your friends and, like, I don't know, if you're, like, happy at them, you'll be like, come on, man, I love you so much. Oh, come here. Oh, yes. Oh, I'm so happy. And then if you, like, suddenly get mad, you, like, grrr, grrr. This looks like a mad cookie or something. I don't know. And then there's a sad post-it. Oh, I'm having a bad day today. And you can just tell. You can, like, have a multiplayer server with a billion people and, like, if you're sad today, you can just put sun, and everybody can be like, oh, why are you sad, Gabs Part 1, why are you sad? Then you just have a sneaky diamond sword in your inventory, and then you just kill them, like, pow, 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 pow. Those game effect sounds, though. And then, right, we have crafter, power crafter pants, and tops, and helmets. So these are basically like armor, and you can get whatever color you want. So there's red, yellow, blue, green, and pink. So let's just take pink, because why not, right? Take off that sad post-it. Let's put on these power craft. Oh, don't I look beautiful? These remind me of Power Rangers. Has anybody ever watched Power Rangers? Back in my childhood days, Power Rangers was the thing, you know? Now you can be Power Rangers in Minecraft. Sick. And you can be whatever color you want. And then for all of these guys, there's the same boots. So I just put on these boots and boom, it looks sick. I may leave this on for the rest of the video. You know what? It looks so cool. I'm actually just going to take off my helmet because, you know. And then there's like a creeper logo. That's so cool. See that? You see that creeper logo? Right there? Yeah. On the chest plate. That looks so cool. So we have all these. And then we have pastel rainbow socks. Rainbow socks. White striped socks and black striped socks. Now, the weird thing is, you would think that you put socks on your legs. I mean, on your feet. But I didn't mean to do that. Alright. You would think that you put them on your feet, but you actually don't. You take them and then you kind of put them on your legs, and if I try putting them on my boots, it won't work. I'm left clicking right now, and it's not working. So, look at that though. It's so sick. It's like a rainbow, like pants. even though they call them socks. I guess you put, technically you put socks on your legs. It's whatever way you want to think of it. Yeah. So we have that, and then we have cat ears. If you love cat ears, we have cat ears. So first we have the normal cat ears. What is great about these normal cat ears? Again, if you have a crafting table and you take dye, you can make them whatever color you want. So I'm just going to be a savage, take purple cat ears because they fit me, don't they? Look at that. Meow, meow, meow. I'm not a ninja anymore. I'm a cat. I'm a savage. Woo, yeah. All right, then we got gold cat ears, zombie cat ears. Calico cat ears. I hope I said that right. Calico cat ears. Is that it? Calico cat ears. Then we got diamond cat ears if you want to be a savage straight up, you know? Diamond. I'm so rich. Got a diamond cat. It's so cool. And then we got a halo, which you probably saw me wearing in the intro because this is like one of my favorite stuff. It gives you protection and you just wear it and you're like, oh, mommy, I'm an angel. Oh. And you can just come to your friends and I'm like, oh, I'm an angel. Woo. And they'd be like, oh, my God, you're weird. I just broke a chest, too. Nobody cares, though. I just broke all the chests and the item frame. Oh, wait, no, I didn't. It's this way. I did break the chest, though. Oopsie. Alright, let's just trash all of this again, because I'm getting tired of it. Except the bikini and the halo, because I like those things, you know? It's pretty cool. It's pretty cool, if I do say so myself. Trash, 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 trash. Oh, I got rid of my diamond cat ears. I really don't know why somebody would spend so much stuff on getting diamond cat ears, but if you love diamond cat ears, then be yourself. Do not be me, but be yourself and get those diamond cat ears, you know? Alright, then we got one of my favorite parts. We got cardboard wings, we got dove wings, we got ender dragon wings, we got glass wings, we got hand wings, and then we got blue hand glider, green hand glider, magenta hand glider, plane wings, raven wings, and vex wings. Now, these aren't just wings that you wear. These wings, oh, you fly them. You fly with these wings. So let's just, oh, goodbye, bikini. I'm so sorry. I love you forever. Not really. Let's put on ender dragon wings. Oh, my God, look at that. That looks so sick. It's like you're the ender dragon or something. Huh? 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 So what are we going to do? Ready? We're going to take some blocks. And we're gonna build up, because we're Minecraft noobs, that's right. Woo! All right, we're just gonna build up here. There we go. Now, if you wanna be a savage, I'm wearing ender dragon wings again. Just go into F5 mode. This isn't just any normal wing. These are an elytra. Elytra! Look at that. Look at these. Look at these babies. Woo! Elytra. So, if I wanna show you the animation. It's so cool. You jump. Woo! Yo, wings! Did you see that? Did anybody see that? Or is it just me? Your wings. Spread apart. What if I fly up, right? And it's just you times that day. Game mode zero really quickly. Woo! Look at that! The wings! Did you see that? That's so cool! I forgot I was in survival, though. I'm smart. Oops. Yeah, but that's so cool. And then we have all the other wings, which I now died. Where'd I die? Give me back my stuff. There we go. Alright, all the other wings now. So you can be an ender dragon. And heck, you can even be a cardboard wing man. You know? If you hate your ender dragon wings, why not just wear cardboard wings, you know? Whee! Like that, see? Elytra. I'm gonna die now. Oops. Look at those cardboard wings, though. Doesn't that look sick, though? Looks so sick. Slash game everyone! Ah! Oh, I didn't die! Yes! That's right. That's right. And look, those cardboard wings, they just unfolded. And now they folded, and it's so cool. It's so cool. So that happens with all the wings. So he can be whatever you want, really. It's so cool. We're not over here. We're over here. Wait for that. You can also wear hang gliders, everything else. I imagine that. Alright, then we got capes. We got the rainbow cape, the curse cape, the cross cape, the creeper cape, the blaze cape, the plane cape, the item bound cape, and the blue haven cape. Let's just take a couple. I took all of them if you didn't realize. Alright, so now that we got all of these, let me just show you. Some of these are just plain old stuff. Stuff. They're stuff, right? Okay? They're just plain old capes. They don't have protection or anything, but they look really cool, let's be honest, okay? Let's be honest. Now, I'm just gonna try on all these capes for you guys. Item bound cape. There we go. You saw it. I know you did. Rainbow cape. No, there we go. That's the rainbow cape. I got the plain cape, which you can color just like the bikini and everything to whatever color you want. We got the curse cape. The curse cape gives you thorns. You don't want to mess with anybody with thorns. You don't want to mess with anybody with thorns. If you don't know what thorns did, then what are you doing with your life? You do not know vanilla. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Thorns is basically if somebody hits you, the damage goes back to them with even more damage. It's sick. So this is like the best cape in the game, okay? Then we got the protection cape. It gives you protection. Who knew? Then we got the blast protection cape, which I was also wearing in the intro. It's a creeper, and it gives you blast protection. Common sense, right? Right? You all knew that. Then we have the blaze cape, just like the blaze bow and everything. It gives you fire protection. So you can go in lava and you'll be safe, which is pretty cool. I mean, I think it's pretty cool. All you need is to go into an anvil, take you take like an iron chest plate or something, and you put it in the anvil, and then you put fire protection, and you have infinite fire protection with that cape. It's awesome. Now we have all the masks, and oh, aren't these masks so beautiful? I love them so much. We got the Alex cap, the Blaze cap, the Cave Spider cap, the Cow mask. We basically have all of the masks that you have in Minecraft. They even have the new stuff that was just added. For example, they have Herobrine. Is that in Minecraft? I don't know. Find out in the next episode of... I don't know. Do you believe in Herobrine? I don't know. Say in the comments section below. Anyway, so we have the Husk Mask, which was just added in 1.11, I think. And then we have the Illager. Those are the new stuff that I added. But again, we have all of these masks, and they're pretty cool. So let's just grab a couple that we really want, okay? Let's grab the Alex Man. No, let's grab... Okay, we have all the masks in here. Let's grab the Herobrine mask. Let's grab the Cow mask. The Alex mask. The Illager mask. Oh, yeah. The Steve mask. The Villager mask. The Vex mask. Mm-hmm. And the Zombie Villager mask, okay? Let's just try some of these on. Why not? Okay, let's go into F5. Boom! Oh my god, I'm a Zombie Villager. That's so cool. Now... Boom! I'm an Illager. I mean a Vex. I knew that. Now, we take this off. Trash. Boom! Boom, 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 boom. Oh, you didn't see that coming, did you? Oh, you didn't see that coming, did you? Villager mask. Steve mask.
Hi, I'm Steve.
Okay, sorry. This is the Illager mask. This is the Alex mask. This is the This is the Cow mask. I'm just saying. And this is the hashtag pranked Herobrine mask. You can come up to your friends and be like, I'm Herobrine. Oh my god, it's Herobrine. Oh my god, it's Herobrine. Everybody run away. He's gonna kill us all. Oh my god. And really, you're just Herobrine, and you're just a master prankster. Now, we have... I like how it was so serious there. Like, nothing happened, you know? I'm just Herobrine, and... yeah. I'm Hero Bright. Nobody will ever destroy me ever because I'm Hero Bright. I'm weird. Let's continue. Alright, so we have all the masks. And then we have block masks. So TNT block, an ender chest, a diamond block, a command block, a wood block. Wait. A command block? The most OP item in Minecraft is a command block, and now you can be a command block. I am a command block. Will, you can do anything. You can be a turtle. You can be a ninja. Heck, you can even be a command block. You can be whatever. Just do it. Do I sound serious with the command block on my head? I don't know. Right, then we got, of course, we have the wool block, the chest block, the glass block, the glowstone block, spawner block, crafting table block, and the grass block. All of these are talents. But the one special thing about the wool block, actually, is I just destroyed it, is, again, if you go and take crafting table, which is back there, let's go to a crafting table. Can we find it? Yes, we can. Nice. You can color it whatever you want. So if you want to be a lime wool block, you can be a lime wool block. Just like I said, you can be any color you want. Magenta. And then you take the... It's on my head, I'm stupid. Wool block. Magenta. Boom! It makes a dyed wool block that's a random color, so you can make whatever color you want. It's so cool. Look at that. Woo! Now I'm this color wool. This color wool doesn't even exist in Minecraft, but... Now it does on my head. Woo! Ah, and that's actually like the almost the same color as the shulker block things. I don't know what it's called. Tell me, please. I'm stupid. Alright. Now, for the last thing in the armor section, we have one of my favorite parts. You can be Alex. You can be Alex. You can be Alex. You can be Steve. You can be Steve. You can be Steve. You can be Slimes. It's so cool. So, let's say you wanted to be Alex for a day, but you're too lazy to change your skin. You put on this armor and make it. Oh my god, I'm Alex. I'm so ugly. I'm sorry if you have an Alex skin, but it's kind of ugly, in my opinion. Now, we have also the Steve set, and then we have the Slime set. So let's just take this ugly set off and become another ugly guy. Steve! Yeah, you're Steve now. And then, the coolest one, you can become a slime. You see that slime on my chest? It's so cool. It's like a face is always stalking you. It's like you have two faces always stalking you. It's so cool. It's so cool. Alright? Your friends would love two faces stalking them, wouldn't they? I know they would. Let's just drop all this trash. Trash, 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 trash. Let's all drop all this trash in the trashy chest, right? Alright, now we're done with armor. Time, set, day, come on, world. No. Slash time. I can spell time. I can spell set. I can spell day. It turns to day. Now we have tools. Actually, we have tools, food, mob drops, and fish. Now you may be wondering, what the heck? There are so many fish. Are you kidding me? There are 22 fish? Yeah, that's right. And the fish are the best part of the mod. It's so cool. Let's take off this. It's so cool. But I'm gonna save that for last. You know? You're gonna have to keep on watching. Alright, we got the golden drill, the iron drill, the diamond drill, and the fork. So if you have a fork or something and your friend's like, what the heck, you have a fork in your inventory? What is that gonna do? Look at this. Slash game mode 0. Look how fast this is. Who? You wish you were me. You wish you were me. Now, this is the slowest thing. But say we took the diamond drill, iron drill, or golden drill. Now this. Boom, 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 boom. Now this. Iron drill. Boom, 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 boom. Now this gets hectic. Look at this diamond drill. Boom, 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 boom. It's so fast. I've never seen such a fast drill thing in Minecraft. It's just so cool. So we have all these drills, and then we have a spoon, which is the only shovel in the game. But it's here. So, if you like shoveling snow just like that, there we go. You got it. Shoveling it right now. There we go. I don't know. Then we got shears, blue scissors, green scissors, red scissors, and a razor. Boom, 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 boom. Can we spawn sheep in this world? Let's see. Sheep? Probably not. Oh, we can! Look, razor. Boom! Let's just spawn a ton of sheep, why not? Boom, 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 boom. Razor, razor, razor it. It's so cool. Look at this thing. It's in, like, in my hotbar, and it's actually a razor. Then we got green scissors, red scissors, and we got blue scissors, which are not in my thingy-ma-bobber. Thank you very much. Also, I'm pretty sure scissors actually give you more wool than a normal shear. So with a normal shear, you have a chance of getting 1 wool to 3 wool. With scissors, I'm pretty sure you always get 2 or 3 wool, which is really, really, really cool and helpful if you like wool, which would be cool, I guess. I've never met anybody who really likes wool. So if you do really like wool, that's pretty cool. Now we got all the food. This is one of my favorite parts in the mod, because, I mean, Minecraft doesn't have much food. It kind of gets boring. This is all the food they give you. But with this mod, you can have, like, tons of food. We got banana, dragon fruit, grapes, lychees, that's how you say it, right? Oranges, pineapples, star fruits. And then we got fried tofu, onigiri, pizza, melon sorbet, melon skewer, honeydew, cantaloupe. Some of these foods are from different countries, and I don't know them. I can't pronounce them. I'm sorry. And we got a brownie, got a creeper cookie, chocolate wafer, strawberry wafer, vanilla wafer, hot chocolate, and almond milk. Then we got ice cream, vanilla ice cream, strawberry, Neapolitan, chocolate, and chocolate. Then we got all these sodas, which are basically like crafted with milk, so if you have potion effects, they get rid of them, which is pretty helpful. So if you are tired of getting rid of your potion effects with stupid old milk, you can get it in fashion now with soy milk, coconut milk, chocolate milk, chocolate milkshake, strawberry milkshake, vanilla milkshake, butterscotch pudding, chocolate pudding, vanilla pudding, and yogurt. Pretty cool. That's all the food. Wait. I just realized something. Wait. Where's it? We have a pineapple. We have an apple. Do you guys know what I'm gonna do? What? Huh? Wait. Just wait for it. Where are the pens? We need a pen. Oh, this is the greatest genius idea ever. Where's the pen? Oh, it's back here. Give me a pen. Thank you. Ahem. I have a pen. I have an apple. Apple pen. I have pineapple. I have a pen. Pineapple pen. I'm sorry. I'm good at singing, right? And does anybody else know that trend? I have a pen, I have an apple, apple pen. Yeah. I hope you know that. If you don't, look up on YouTube, pen, pineapple, apple pen after you finish watching this video. Then, my favorite part of the mod is not here yet. All right, we have mob drops now. We have ashes, creeper, I'm sure, okay. Ashes is a blaze drop. Creeper hide is a creeper drop. Calamari is a squid drop. Cursed diamond is a witch drop. Vial of glowstone is a witch drop. Vial of redstone, witch drop. Oh, a witch's thumb? Ew! Oh, that's just nasty. Ugh. I'm just gonna pretend I didn't see that. We have a wither skeleton drop, which is a carbon bone, and then we have a zombie pigment drop, which is zombie bacon. So if you ever wanted bacon, and you love zombies, now you have zombie bacon, and it does poison you, so I'm sorry. It does hunger you, whatever. So this is everything. And then this cursed diamond, it gives you thorns, which is pretty sick. So basically, you can't craft any of these. Actually, you can craft these items, except the cursed diamond, I believe, which you have to get from a witch. And then these things are mob drops again. Yeah, and then basically, the cursed diamond, if I were to go into game mode zero right now, it would take me to half a heart, which I am not going to do because I do not want to go to half a heart. Thank you very much. All right, now, for the favorite part of Gabsport 1 in Itembound 2016. If you're watching, actually, this is 2017, I'm stupid. If you're watching in 2018 or anything other than that, then this was recorded in 2017. But we have an angelfish, an anglerfish. Oh, by the way, this is the fish. We have the anglerfish, we have the butterfly fish, we have the regalfish, mantis fish, stingray, zebra fish, kuakalank, manta ray, moray eel, and ocean sunfish. Then we got green algae, fish skeleton, fire coral, which sets enemies on fire and reduces the player's HP by a few hearts. So if I grab this right here, and I was to use it, it would give the player fire aspect, and it would kill. It would light them on fire, and it does like 5 hearts of damage. It's really strong. Then we have the sea anemone. Then we have the desanitizer jellyfish, which has the player movement speed, that adds 5 units of armor. So if I were to take this and go into game mode zero. So, if I were to... I don't have... Where was it? I'm smart. Oops. Yeah, but if I was to go into game mode zero, and I have something disabled right now for my recording options, so it doesn't do that, but if I was not recording right now, then it would slow you down, and it would add 5 units of armor. Then... we have the Blood Lamprey, which I said in the intro, it gives a player an HP boost when held in the offhand slot, which is pretty cool, Then, so basically the offhand slot is if I hold this and then I press F, it's right here, see? It's like, I can dual wield the pen and the pineapple. Oh wait, I got a belly. I have a pen, I have an apple. Apple pen, I have pineapple, I just realized I'm singing again. Sorry, I get carried away sometimes. Please don't blame me. Alright. Alright, so we got the moon jellyfish, the sea slug. Then we got a sea urchin, which can be used to deal damage to enemies. So it's basically kind of like a sword from the sea, which you can catch with a fishing rod. And then we got the lion mane's jellyfish. And then we have the enderfish, which randomly teleports the player within a limited radius. Well, that's a zoomed in thing of you. It's an enderfish. Randomly teleports you. Yeah. So, that's all the fish, and that's how you catch them. It's 5 times a day, you stupid thing. You catch these all with a fishing rod, actually. So, you can actually craft these with pufferfish and all types of the other fish, whatever it's called. Fish. Yeah. You can craft it with clownfish, pufferfish, and rawfish, and a kickfish. You can craft these things, but if you craft them, they actually won't give you the special abilities. You have to catch them legitimately with a fishing rod from the sea. That way you're not cheating to get awesome special abilities. Now, for the last thing before we end this awesome tutorial thing. This. We have custom books, and it's so cool. These are not all the books. I could not do all the books. There are about 300 types of different patterns of books and colors, and it's so cool. But this is how you make them. This is the custom book station. Ho ho. There we go. Custom bake station. You take a book and quill, and you write stuff. So, what's up, Gabs? But one, I spelled with step run, nobody cares. Gabsport 1 is awesome, lol, troll. Then we sign it. You have to sign the book before you can do this. I name it Troll, lol, lol, lol. I am awesome. I can't do that, but whatever. Tra-la-la-la-la-la. I. We put it in here, right? Put it in here, and then after this, we put a space, and then you rename it whatever you want. Kind of. So, there are letters of the alphabet, and then there are numbers, right? Each color gives you a different color. So, if I put S4, it turns it into white. If I put B2, it turns it into this blue thing. Which kind of makes sense, because B stands for blue, and then there are different types of blue. Like that, like that, like that. So many blues, so many blues, am I right? I'm right. We got green. You see all these different types of green. So if you really like want to just, let's make this nice green. If you want to send your friend a nice custom book, which is colored or has patterns on it, then I named these books. What's up, mates? Have a good day. Smiley face. You guys are now having a good day because of me. You're welcome. Anyways. I'm going to read you off what I wrote here. It's so beautiful. What's up, mates? Have a good day. See you guys next time. Subscribe and like the vid for to know when I post vids and to become part of the mate squad. Anyways, if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like or thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to me if you haven't, and for more awesome videos. I will see you guys next time. Remember, this is a resource pack called Itembound, the link to how to craft everything in here, and how to the link to the download will be in the description below. I'll see you guys next time. GabSpot 1, out.
Everything changes.